was mooted at a conference which Granada held each year to discuss next year's output in drama. And it was the latter end of 1969. But to qualify to attend the conference, you had to put in an idea. And although I desperately wanted to attend, I'd left it rather late. And I sat down, did a bit of scribbling, and the word conflict kept coming up. And I had for some time played with the idea for a series about the war, but Blitz cities were being rebuilt. It was some 25 years after the E-Day, and planes and ships were being scrapped, armies disarmed. It seemed likely that with costs rising, a budget would be prohibitive. And then I remembered Mrs. Ross. She was a working woman with two sons who had won scholarships to university but decided to join the RAF, and neither of them survived. And I thought of my own mother, divorced and with a disabled daughter, and I was the man of the house, so to speak. And if I'd been lost at sea when I served in the Merchant Navy, our family would have been decimated too. It seemed to me that the wartime threat to families had not been fully absorbed by the medium. The conference was attended by some very well-known writers. They came up from London in a steady stream. Really, everyone in those days, they all wanted to work for Granada because Granada had a very good reputation in drama. And when ideas started to roll out, it became quickly apparent that the one that was most interesting to the management, in the person of Sir Dennis Foreman, was a family at war. And it was an instant success. I mean, he backed it completely. Immediately, it became obvious that we were going to go ahead with it. All sorts of problems arose. The availability of writers who understood the period, actors who hopefully had some experience of the wartime background.
The iconic ITV series, A Family at War. Join us 8 p.m. Sundays and Wednesdays only on Talking Pictures TV.